Yes.
As to where it comes in the opera or whatever.
Absolutely. Would you have?
I've got some here.
Okay, yeah. Great.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Shafali Jalota. This aria that I will be singing for you is Se Padre Perdei from Mozart's Idomeneo. And in this aria, I am Emilia. I'm a Trojan princess. Exciting. I'm a Trojan princess.
you know, don't do too much
yeah.
so that we get a bit distracted. Just
yes.
just maybe a little less.
Yeah.
When the verse comes back at the end, saying Padre, Perdei,
yeah.
Or joy, all that stuff. The harmony is different this
yeah.
time. It's not so sure. The first
yeah.
time when she sings it, when you sing it seems very that like she's accepting it.
Yes.
But then the second time, it's not quite so sure. So I think we need to show with that change of harmony that there's a sort of, am I betraying everything I've ever stood for?
Yeah.
Like, am I really, I'm in love with the son of the leader who's wiped out my family, and now
yeah.
he's saying he could be my new dad, you know,
right.
in effect.
Yes.
It's not quite how you expected things to turn out.
No.
So, to say the least. And, you know, as I say, when the trouble is with these arias, they repeat a very short sentence so many times, so we need to find colour.
Mm-hmm.
So, maybe in a way, have a map.
Yeah.
Have, you know, the first time you say it, say, Padre, Perdei. Padre,
Padre,
you say, yeah, Rather than maybe repeat it 50 times, just so we
Thank you.
it makes it far more dangerous. Mm-hmm. You know, far more dangerous. And I wonder the whole of this aria, is she singing it to him or is she singing it to herself? You know what I mean? Is she giving herself the courage to propel him into it? But I think a lot of these big moments will be, I mean, they were very effective, but I think they'll be even more effective if they come from nowhere. This is what Verdi excels at. You know, he takes a tiny, it doesn't matter what kind of role it is, there's David or a lady by Beth, it doesn't matter. He'll take a tiny kernel of sound and from that will come something.
Yeah.
And then go back again.
I think no one gets scared of it because
yeah.
I haven't done it before.
Okay.
It's like,
yeah. Yeah, I think they've got the whole character, you know, you just feel like you've got to give it the whole time. I think the more, almost inner way you can do this, the more scary she is.
Yeah.
I think if she comes on all guns blazing, then you go, yeah, she's just a, you know, a tough nut. But I think you want to feel that this is like a coiled spring, you know? Let's just have a little look. And I think also, then, if you don't put so much weight in the middle of the sound, middle area, the top, which of course you have, but it doesn't quite match at the moment.
Yeah.
It kind of thins out a little bit, and I think that's probably because you're giving it too much oomph, especially in the passaggio.
Yeah.
And if you use these, I mean, these guys, they're very good at giving you a kind of roadmap in terms of pacing.
Yeah.
So when you have all these pianissimo sections, you just know that in a page or half a page, it's going to be a huge bit. You know, so in a way, he's giving you that kind of downtime in order to come back.
Yeah.
So follow, let's just go, Ambizioso Spirto, to say, like, you hate it, really. You want the glory. It's all about you. So in a way, he's just the pathway to what you want. Yeah. So she said, check the bum bum bum, he's giving you those accents. Mm. They write all these instructions. How many? Three. I'm sure you're making this up. Guitar, even if we just get this far, it's a roadmap. Yeah. Let's do guitar, then go a bit
every day life. Thank you.
going to be my husband. Yeah, everything tells me that's the case, but I can't accept it if it's not the top. I can't do that. I can't marry him. It's all the shame. We need to feel that these thoughts aren't pre-prepared. That's the problem when we learn things on the page. Of course, we have a vision. I don't know about you, but I see the page in front of my head, and I go, it's three bars. We've got to get rid of that, and we've got to, the ink has still got to be wet.
Yeah.
In other words, it's got to be that these thoughts come out of what you've just said.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
So we never know quite, you don't know. You have to forget you've learned it.
Mm-hmm.
So now you have to just react to what you've just said and respond. Okay, let's just pull the bars in. So in the
No!
Yeah. Scritto with my sadness is written into heavens.
Yeah.
Su crudel.
Su crudel.
Thank you.
busy you get operatically, you know, they inform how we perform on a bigger scale if we can perform in a small kind of little miniature like this.
Mm.
Yeah, good. I think German, we look at it on the page, lots and lots of h's and h's. But we need to hear it. We need to hear those, and they won't distract from the line. The tendency is to go, there's far too many consonants, so I'll just kind of skim over them. Not that you were all the time, there were moments when I think, you know, like the very beginning, horch. There's a long way to get into the vowel. Horch. The murmen. Murmen. Use these consonants more because they cover the word. Yeah? Can we just go over and say all of that again? Cut the bars in. Moaning, stöhnen, to moan, to be dumpfig tief, ein schweres, a really, don't let it come off the body at all. Can we do a Stört? Stört was great.
Stört, dumpfig tief, ein
No, 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 no,
So now, he's saying their eyes are hollow and they're looking anxiously towards the Concitos, to the bridge of, it's one of the five rivers that encircles Hades. So it's not cheery. Yeah? So we need to feel this fear. You know, the hell is all around. It's show that in the face, you know, that it's, but I think hall still needs a longer hall. Hall's interior, not hall. Don't be afraid to change the colour, to sing piano.
Okay.
You know, piano is good.
Und sei, und noch nicht vollendet und sei.
Off the stage by this person, it's at a voice. going like this, it's not coming out. And you know, it's all about getting it to the back of the wall, but without forcing. It's all to do with focus and projection. Yeah.
One of the things that's really striking watching this format is how admirably vulnerable the performers make themselves, right? Because it's always a vulnerable on stage, but I think particularly when you're inviting, as they have, very grateful to you all, but inviting the sort of the precision of the criticism and the... I suppose my question to you is how, if you reflect back on your development as a performer, what was that journey for you? Is there a point at which you feel like, I'm not going to take criticism from anyone anymore, I sort of
no,
close it down, do you feel you're still on every time?
In public, and she was renowned for annihilating people. I mean, nastily so. I remember it was New Year's Eve 1981. I was standing there thinking, what on earth am I doing here, being just humiliated by this woman? And in fact, it really, it was quite damaging for a while. And my teacher was in the audience. And for some reason, because I took it for a bit and then I thought, no, I'm not having this. I mean, I might not know everything and I might be a kid, but actually I am trying and I'm being accused of not trying, and that's not cool. And I fought back a bit, and my teacher said, oh, there's something in that woman that brings something out in you, which is really interesting because the results were great. So she made me go to her house in Zurich and have lessons with her. And when I opened the door, when she opened the door, this creature that had been on the stage, a complete horrible person, was just a little old lady in a jumper and a skirt, and we sat and watched ice skating together. And it was actually incredibly different, the difference between her public persona and her real persona. I remember thinking that if I ever was lucky enough to be able to do a class like this, then you know, you've got that experience was in the back of my mind, that it's always trying to get the best out of somebody. But I think there's, you never ever stop. I mean, I still have singing lessons, I still go to coaching, you never stop. I'm 63, you know, so it doesn't finish ever until you decide not to do it anymore. So I think that there isn't a point where, I think you get better at dealing with it and sort of sifting through it. I mean, everything that's been said today, it's just ideas. You don't have to do it, it's not set in stone, but it's just throwing out possibilities to try and just widen the process of thinking and reacting, and just maybe concentrating a little bit more on what's on the page, because we sometimes get carried away with the actual making the sound. So, you know, there's always something to learn from somebody, and then I guess the way it works best is then you take a bit of this and a bit of that, and it's like making a meal. You know, you chuck a bit of oregano in, a bit of pepper, and see what happens. And you kind of have a melange of ideas that you then formulate in your own way. It has to be personal, otherwise you're just a kind of singing robot, which is not good.
Yeah. Do you have any advice or anything you sort of wish you'd been told or wish you'd known when you were young?
Very much junior. You know, I would go and bang on their door, the planning office, every June and say, when am I going to get a go? Yeah. Well, I'm coming out and going, here's your hat, here's your coat, and off we go again, you know. And they just, wait. So curb the impatience, you know. Be realistic about what you can do now and capitalise on that, and then just slowly build the experience.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm really curious to know whether and see whether you are able to tell whether you're singing well and whether they're in tune. Have you ever tried
a classical sort of
Persian vocalist?
No, I haven't. I have to say
I'm always very curious to see.
No, but I'll try and do that.
No, I haven't.
No.
Looking at the Persian carpets, I'd be very curious to know whether.
Yeah. I think it's probably a very different style of producing the sound.
Yes.
And the music is of a different, probably the pictures are slightly more indeterminate than say Schubert or Mozart or something. It's slightly more.
Okay.
But it's not something I've looked into, but I will.
Thank you.
Get Mr. Google out.
Thank you.
Yes, it
sorry. I was going to ask, did you find that you perhaps turned down contracts when you were younger or things that they weren't suitable or you wanted to do something that wasn't suitable or did you do something and then that was the kind of the door to you going, oh okay, I'm learning this stuff or
No, I turned things down because people could hear in my voice where it was going, but I didn't trust it at that point, so I didn't want to. Yeah, I had to feel inside me that I could do it. And in the end, you know, all the people in the world can tell you yes, no. But you're the one on the stage at the end. They're not there doing it for you. It comes from you, and so you've got to really believe that you can do it. But yeah, I think having a good pair of ears around you, a teacher or a coach, and building a career is much more. I mean, so much now is instant, everything's instant. You know, 1 minute you're working in Tesco's, then you're an opera singer. No, you're not. It's not the case. And you've got to look at the long journey. I mean, you know, next year or the year after, I'm going to do something at the Coliseum, which 30 years exactly before, I'm going to do the mum in the opera where I did the daughter, you know. But 30 years ago, I had no idea then that I'd be coming back to do that. But that's the journey. If you want to have a long career, don't be tempted to do things instantly now because, you know, unfortunately there are lots and lots and lots and lots of singers, and if you mess up, then out you go and the next one will come in. So be very careful. You have one voice, one career. Take care of it. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.